Action.
Title of this book is called The Fault in Our Stars, and it's by John Green. The genre of this book is realistic fiction, because some things in this book can happen to you in real life, and some things can't. I have not read any of the books by this author. This is the first one I read, and I just haven't been able to get hold of any of the books. But this book is pretty easy to read. The words are not, like, they're not any words scribbled into one page. It's pretty much spacing in the words. The main plot of the story kind of is like, there's this girl named Hazel Grace. She was affected by lung cancer at a very young age. She kind of gave up on life after that. She didn't go to school. She didn't make too many friends. But then this one day, her mom sent her to this cancer place. The other people who are affected with cancer, and she makes friends there, and after that she meets the guy named Augustus Waters, and a lot of things happen. I think the purpose of the author's writing is that when something happens to you, don't let it break you, just continue life and live it to the full. I'm going to read a paragraph from page 121, chapter 8, and it's the 41st paragraph.
Nice and loud.
The sky was gray and dull, and full of rain, but not yet raining. I hung up when I got Augustus' voicemail, and then put the phone down in the dirt beside me, and kept looking at the swing set, thinking that I would give up all the 6 days I had left for a few healthy ones. I tried to tell myself that it could be worse, that the world was not a wish-granting factory, that I was living with cancer, not dying with it, that I mustn't let it kill me before it killed me. And then I just started muttering, stupid, 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 over and over again until the sound unhinged from its meaning. And I was still saying it when he called back. I think that the book in general explains a general explanation of the book. I think it's really good because it tells you, like, if you're affected by something, like, never give up. And it was a really fun read. I read it twice, right? But it was a pretty fun read, and I enjoyed reading it. People who like books like not the Percy Jackson series, not of that, some kind of dramatic book, if you guys know any of it, that's if you're into realistic fiction, you would kind of like this book. Is there any questions?
I remember that someone I forgot told me that this book was also about milk. Is that true?
Yeah.
With?
Yeah,
they're playing it.
Yeah, no, take all that.